want to start off by asking, now I know that you're a survivor, so please tell me what happened.
I was 27 years old, and I went for a regular routine checkup. I have really bad allergies. So this particular year, I told my husband, you know, I think I'm going to get an allergy shot. So I went to my physician specifically for an allergy shot. She does a regular checkup every time you go in. And at this particular time, my EKG came back a little abnormal. So she had me lay down and in a quiet room, and she said, well, let's just do it again. We did it the second time, and the EKG was still showing some abnormal readings. So at that time, she sent me to the hospital from her office, and everything got started from there.
Now, what was happening? Were you having a heart attack?
No, I was not having a heart attack. Thank God I have not had a heart attack. After several tests, visiting a cardiologist, they diagnosed me with cardiomyopathy, which just basically means that my heart muscle is abnormal.
So walk me through what was going through your head when, you know, when your allergy doctor tells you you're going to the hospital.
Denial, because I'm superwoman. I had four kids, and I had a husband to tend to, and nothing was wrong with me. I was fine. And she said, no, you're not. And we actually kind of argued, debated in the doctor's office before I really said, yeah, I'll go ahead and go. It wasn't until the next day that I found out the results. And when she called, I was at work. She asked me where my husband was, and that was just kind of odd. And I said, well, he's getting ready to leave for work. And she said, well, I need you to have him bring you to my office. And so I asked why. And she said, well, just have him bring you to my office. And I said, you know, no, tell me what's going on. And so she said, are you sitting down? And that's when she let me know that my ejection fraction was 25. The normal rate is 55 to 70. And she told me, her words were that my heart was beating like I was an 8-year-old mom. My husband took me to her office. It was very emotional because we didn't know what was going on, why. And everything started from there. She set me up with amazing doctors at Stern Cardio. I do have a heart history in my family. My father passed at 40 waiting on a heart transplant. And my brother, I'm happy to say, just received a heart transplant in September this year, and he's 40. So it's really surreal for us.
Now, looking back, I know you said you're a superwoman. You could do anything. Now that you're here, looking back, were there any signs that you now know were red flags that you didn't know at the time?
There were red flags, but I mistook them for weight gain. I had a daughter, the baby. I gained 60 pounds during my pregnancy, and I would have palpitations. I would have my legs hurt all the time. The shortness of breath when I would get up and go places, but I just said, I need to lose weight. But my doctor quickly told me that that's not, yes, it's part of the weight gain, but your heart is not pumping like it should.
Now, how is your family reacting to all of this?
It was very hard at first, especially when the doctors took me off of work. I think that's when it really set in how severe the situation was. My husband took it worse than anybody because we have four daughters. And so the question was, is my wife going to be here for us? I am the rock for the family. I'm the carpool person, I'm the dinner person, you know, and all of that could go away, you know, in a matter of seconds. So it was a very, very disturbing time.
Now, where you stand now, and you said you have a family history, what is your advice to your daughters?
My advice is don't. Age doesn't matter. It can happen to anybody. Don't ignore the symptoms. If anything is wrong with your body, if something just doesn't seem right, go see a doctor. Listen to your heart. It speaks to you. Listen to all of your body parts. I've learned through this journey that women's signs and symptoms aren't like men's. And so we could have things that are going on with us and we just don't realize it. So just pay attention.
All right? You're doing fantastic. Now, only thing I want you to do is to say, go red for women.
Go red for women.
That was awesome. All right, let me have you do it two more times.
Go red for women. Go red for women.
Perfect.
She got that from me. I told her to do a little jazz with go red for women.
Love it.